Can you give us a quick synopsis of Breakfast with Johnny Wilkinson? What's the film all about?
Yeah, well, it's about turning up at a typical English rugby club on the morning of November the 22nd, 2003 to watch the game live with everybody else in the club. But unfortunately, my character, Dave Dowson, his email account was hacked, and an email was sent to all the members of the club to tell them not to turn up because there'd been fire damage. That's a lie. That was one of the other characters in the play trying to make me look bad so that he could become chairman of the club instead of me. So it's not, it is about rugby, but it's really about the politics and relationships of the seven people who do turn up on that morning to watch the game.
Of course, I mean, in a lot of ways, your character in the film, it's a little bit different from what we've seen from you before. I mean, is that something that attracted you to the role?
I'm the straight man, aren't I? Everybody else gets the laugh and I stand in the middle being the straight guy. That was what attracted me, you know, to try and, you know, when you're an actor, you want to challenge yourself. I know that sounds a bit, you know, sounds awful actually, sounds a bit lovely. But yeah, to play the straight man amongst everybody else getting the laughs was an absolute pleasure for me to do. And then to be chosen for the part in a movie as well. I've never done a movie. This is the first time ever. Lots of television stuff, but never a movie. To be standing here talking to you guys, it's just, I don't know, it's surreal.
Obviously it's exciting, but what are the other differences between your experiences on stage and on television versus making a movie?
I think television and the stuff that I did with Gareth Hale, obviously when we were doing Hale and Pace, it was quite larger than life because sketch shows, the characters have to be instantaneous. They've only got 3 minutes to make a mark, you know. With something like this, when you're playing a character that lasts for 90 minutes, you'd better be as real as you possibly can be. Otherwise, people are going to say, no, that's wrong, I don't believe it anymore. So the only thing I've aimed for in doing this film is to try to be consistent in my characterization of Dave Dowson across the whole 90 minutes. And only the people who come to see it will know whether that's worked or not. I'm not the best judge of that.
Of course, I mean, like you say, you're playing sort of the straight man. What's the tone of the film like overall? I mean, are some of the other characters a little bit larger than life?
Yeah, the two male characters are two other male characters who are at the forefront of it, are very, very funny, one Australian, one English, and they sort of dance around with their comedy around the other characters in the room. So I would say it's got a heart of gold, this film. It makes everybody smile that I know has seen it. It certainly made me smile. I came out of the cinema feeling better when I saw it the first time. So all in all, I just think it's a good thing. Go and see it and you'll have a good laugh.
Of course, Simon, your director, what was it like working with him?
Simon Spracling, dedicated. He would go home at the end of filming exhausted and stay up until 2 a.m. planning the next day's shooting. And he's the first and last on site every day. He spent a year editing it to give it the filmic look that it needs so that it doesn't look like a play. He's just a completely dedicated, wonderful individual and did a great job.
And of course, at the other end of the spectrum age-wise, you've got young George, who's a very rapidly rising star. I mean, what do you think distinguishes him as such a promising young talent?
Well, he's just got everything. He understands. He connects. And you know, he and I, in spite of our age differences, got on like a house on fire. I think he calls me his naughty Uncle Norm or something. So I was always encouraging him to go to the pub and have a couple of pints more than he should have. And also, you know, being the master of the smutty joke, I laid a few of those on the boy. And so he's grown up a little bit from knowing me.
Were there any particular gems that you treated him to that you could share with us now?
No, just banter on a daily basis. You know, when you're on a film set, you're there for 12 hours a day for 5 weeks. And a lot of the time, they're relighting or waiting for something. So, you know, it's actually quite dull. So you do whatever you can to amuse yourself. And fortunately, with this lot, we all got on like a house on fire. They're all brilliant. And we'll remain friends. And that's not always the case in showbiz.
Finally, and on a slightly more serious note, obviously tonight's event is in aid of the Dallaglio Foundation, a wonderful cause which we fully support. How important do you think it is to get behind it?
Well, I know how hard Lawrence has worked to set it up and how, you know, he physically has worked with his bike rides and everything else. I've been involved with charities. I have a disabled daughter and I understand how difficult it is to get a charity off the ground, and to do it so successfully is brilliant. It's a great job and it's a pleasure for me to be here tonight to support them.